Welcome back to Pax Christi. As I am speaking to you now, one of our parishioners, age 16, is undergoing open-heart surgery at a nearby hospital. Yesterday, the family gathered with me in our parking lot to celebrate the sacrament of anointing of the sick because the building was closed because of the holiday. There is so much going on in the lives of our community members, of which most of us are unaware, which is why the ministry of prayer is so important. I'm grateful that our dedicated pray-ers are so faithful and for the fact that people know that they can request that great gift whenever and for whatever reason they wish, whether personally or anonymously, whether for themselves or for others. I try to remind myself often that when I encounter members of our community without knowing them very well, I generally have no idea what kinds of worries and burdens they are carrying around from day to day. I don't know what scars they bear from past hurts or what hopes they secretly hold in their hearts for the future, maybe frustrated hopes. Another friend of mine is at the Mayo Clinic today being treated for advanced stage cancer, only recently diagnosed. He's in the prime of his life. None of you would likely know him, and I wouldn't be the one to tell you about him, but it's part of what I am concerned about today. It's part of my own prayers and grief and fear. I know for me, it can be easy to overlook all that when I encounter people whom I regard as difficult or angry or confrontative. We all walk around with our own unexpressed anxieties and disappointments. Our staff of pastoral care and support here at Pax is meant to be some measure of help when those things threaten to become overwhelming. Not everyone will choose to approach our community for accompaniment that way, but they still want to be among us. And that calls out for the virtue of compassion in all of us, even when we may not know the whole story of another person's suffering. And this is bigger than I or you or Pax Christi. As I've looked at the images of the violence in Washington, D.C. last week, and the preparations for possible violence here in Minnesota this week, a part of me has wondered, what has made people so angry, so frustrated, so hopeless, that the only felt way out is to harm other people and property? I can't really know, but I can try to listen, and I can pray, yes, even for them. There's a deep wound beneath the rage, and I can do something better than to rage back. We all can. Be well.